Let's talk about filters. You put a bunch of things into them, only some of those things come out the other end.
I'm filtering right now.
To understand what synthesizer filters are filtering, let's see what waveforms are made of.
Your precious coffee, gratefully accepted. I shall be drinking it.
Hey there, what's up to?
Not much, just making doggies and coffee.
To demonstrate filtering?
Yeah, why?
Mocha pots don't have that kind of filter. I think he's played you. Was getting coffee part of your plan?
Of course.
And why are you dressed like that?
I've just seen the new Batman film. It's very topical.
I don't think you have, doggy. It's not out yet.
For you.
You know he's going to be up all night. This is a spectrum analyzer. It shows you which frequencies are present in any waveform. What are you doing?
No one cared who I was, so I put on the mask.
I know you are, doggy. Look, see how your voice is made up of lots of different frequencies?
Ah, you think analysis is your ally.
When you say wow, you're filtering your own voice. You can sound brighter or duller by letting out more or less high frequencies. Look. Wow. Wow. Wow.
If an oscillator is like your vocal cords, making a pitch sound, then a filter is like your mouth, removing parts of that sound. That's why it's called subtractive synthesis.
Oh, I didn't miss it, did I? Are we filtering yet?
No, they expect us to get some more knowledge, brother.
You can think of any waveform as being made up of lots of different sine waves, each one a different frequency and volume. Here's a sine wave. Filtering simply makes some of those sine waves quieter while leaving others alone. If you've only got one lone sine wave to begin with, then filtering is pretty pointless. You either make it quieter or you won't. Triangle waves aren't much better. But a sound made up of lots of different sine waves can be interesting to filter, such as a sawtooth wave. A sawtooth wave has lots of sine waves in it. We call these extra sine waves harmonics. Each harmonic is a multiple of the frequency of the waveform's pitch. So one is the same speed, one is twice as fast, one's three times as fast, and so on. Because they're exact multiples, they make a static shape, and we perceive them as a single whole. The more harmonics a waveform has, the more interesting it sounds when filtered.
Oh, can I filter it now?
Sure.
Yay. Oh, am I doing it right? Am I filtering?
Yes, the cutoff point rises.
A low-pass filter lets the low frequencies pass through while blocking the high ones. The cutoff point is where we draw the line between which frequencies are let through and which aren't. So by twiddling the cutoff point knob, you can make the sound duller and brighter. This is a multi-mode filter, meaning it has multiple modes. So instead of listening to the low-pass output, we can listen to the high-pass output. This lets the high frequencies pass through while blocking the low ones.
That sounds quite different.
Yes.
A bandpass filter lets only the frequencies near the cutoff point pass through. And a notch filter lets everything but the frequencies near the cutoff point pass through, notching them out. As well as turning down some frequencies, you can also turn up the volume of the frequencies at the cutoff point. This is called resonance, and it's at the heart of acid house.
Because they were first performed on Roland's TB-303, Acid lines involve sweeping the cutoff point down with every note, just like the 303 does, and also noodling around with the cutoff point manually. Acoustic sounds also tend to lose their higher harmonics before their lower ones. By exaggerating the range of this sweep and adding resonance to emphasize it, we can take this natural phenomenon and exaggerate it into a stylized synthetic version that's larger than life.
Although different filters do roughly the same thing, they can sound quite different, especially when you crank up the resonance. Let's go from an Oberheim SEM style filter to a Moog style filter. Some filters even resonate so much that they self-oscillate, essentially playing an additional note at the cutoff point. Now you can really hear that downward sweep with every note.
Ah, filters oscillating all by themselves! With more oscillators!
In practice, you can't really block all frequencies on one side of the cutoff point while letting through all the frequencies on the other. There's always a slope. How gentle or steep the slope is contributes to your sound. This slope's quite gentle. It's 6 decibels, meaning that for every octave above the cutoff point, it's made that frequency 6 decibels quieter. And at the cutoff point itself, it's already 3 decibels quieter. Let's try a much steeper, 48 decibels slope. See how there's a much sharper drop-off now? Each octave above the cutoff point is now 48 decibels quieter than the last, and the cutoff point itself is 24 decibels quieter. The slope can also be measured in poles, like a tent, with each pole adding another 6 decibels of steepness to the slope.
But enough talk!
Exactly. You can simply experiment and do what sounds good for your own particular music.
Yes, we take music back from the industry and its massive opportunity, and we give it back to you, the people. Music is yours. None shall interfere. Do as you please. But start by sponsoring us on Patreon. We have raised an army with the true heroes, Tony Ray Andrews, Christopher, Atom Fellows, L, Preston Manis, Tracy Martin, Skippity Boo, and Melvin Sua. Music will be given away. Videos will be liked. Links will be shared. Either viewer will subscribe.
You know, Zoe, I have this fantasy. We're both sitting in the kitchen drinking coffee, and you don't say anything, and neither do I. We don't need to, because we both know that you're not going to give Doggy coffee ever again.
Ooh, nice bean mask.
Oh, perhaps Tom Hardy lives here.
If Tom Hardy lived here, there'd be the script for whatever he's working on lying around. This guy wants to be Tom Hardy, and those are two totally separate things.
I'll be taking that for good.
Okay. Action. You know, Zoe, I've got this fantasy, right? We're in the kitchen, we're drinking coffee, you don't say nothing, I don't say nothing, because we know we're not giving this bloody dog coffee ever again. No, it's okay. It's okay.